Ta-da!
Are we live yet?
There we go, we are live.
Matt's live.
Hey!
Hey!
Right.
It's off to a good
welcome
start.
Welcome to the Canvas. Right. Okay, so if you remember last session, we had managed to find the Vizier's Turban as soon as we worked out what it was that we were supposed to be finding. Having gone and seen the Sultana, you then ended up heading back to the Caravanserai. So after a good meal at the Caravanserai, everybody beds down to sleep for the night. Nabil lies awake. The comforting presence of Barbossa is in his usual place. The warmth of the simian's body through the blanket against his back is juxtaposed with the somewhat more disconcerting feel of another mind close against his. And Bill feels the tension of not wanting to relax too much in case the thoughts that he'd rather were private were picked up. Sagira's easy and confident assertion that he should just relax doesn't entirely help with the raw feeling of vulnerability that he's got. Eventually, Nabil falls asleep and wakes up after a very deep sleep, fully rested. And immediately the too close presence is there, like a stranger unexpectedly lying against you. It's definitely going to take some getting used to. And sitting up, Nabil feels well rested but slightly weak. And as he throws his legs off the bed, Sagira's voice is immediately there in his mind saying, "Carefully, carefully, you've nourished me. You're going to feel tired for a time." As he does every morning, he reaches for his spellbook, aware of Yusef cleaning himself for prayer opposite. As he leafs through the book, this morning there's a new hunger awakened. It's almost as if it's the first time that he's turned the pages. He can feel the mental rooms in his brain filling as he focuses on absorbing the concepts and geometry of the spells. But unlike a normal morning, as he finishes the fourth spell, he can feel a void still open, ready to pour more information into. Carefully trying to see what's possible, he manages to learn a fifth spell, and as he goes for a sixth, he can hear Sakira's voice almost laughing in his head, saying, "Whoa there, Desert Rider, you're not ready for more than that now. Your brain would literally liquefy with more magic than that. Soon you'll be ready. Just don't be impatient." In some ways, Sagira reminds him of Master Mutamin. She's going to take quite some getting used to. So, over a breakfast of black olives, fresh bread, new cheese and honey, you all ponder whether to press straight on and head to Sakina Falls or go and ask some more questions about Yodfa and his residence. What would you like to do?
I'm going to finish my praying and get ready. I'm doing a lot of praying recently.
Yeah. Oh, you have to meditate every morning to get your spells.
That's meditate. Right.
So.
I think it would be a good idea to find out some more things about his house. About how it's sort of set up and whether there's a way we can sort of blag our way in without just trying to sneak.
Whether or not you're going to be able to work out which one it is, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds good.
I don't know who we would ask, though. I don't know.
Probably the right town to ask.
James is saying he doesn't think too many should go out and ask questions if you do go out and ask.
Yeah, being a Mamluk, probably not the best of ideas for me, I don't think.
as a Mamluk, you get if you are a Mamluk with other people, you have a certain amount of anonymity. Mamluks are often used as bodyguards, so you could if you were going out, especially if you were going out with Yazid, say, who's that little bit older, it would probably appear that he was better off than he was, and that you were out there going with him.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Call them both a bit more respect.
Yeah. James is saying he thinks maybe you should only send out Jafar, given that you guys are being kind of posed as powerful scholars. I think before you got arrested, if I remember rightly, you were going to the main souk that does jewellery. Because Yodfa is a jewel merchant.
Yeah.
Muluk.
Yes. I remember that now.
And I think, Charlie, you said that you were wondering whether or not it was the right place to ask questions, kind of the right town. Yeah. It's the only town along the river inland from Muluk. So it's kind of... You've got as far as Simbaya. You've then got Sakina Falls. There isn't really. I don't think there's it. Well, you're not aware of any more settlements between Simbaya and Sakina Falls, and you're not sure what kind of settlement, if any settlement, is at Sakina Falls.
Okay, so perhaps we should continue our original plan and get some precious stones or diamonds, go into the jewelers and get ready for our final mission while we're finding out, which is the original reason for coming here.
Yeah. Where were we going to get the precious jewels or stones from?
Ah, now we were going to go to a jeweler's somewhere, weren't we? We'd arranged.
There is a jewelry souk slightly to the west, slightly to the southwest of the palace, because that was where you were just approaching that when all hell broke loose out the previous day.
Perhaps it's time to return there.
Yeah.
I'm not sure Jafar should go on his own.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, do we send Jafar and I've forgotten all of your character's name.
Anwar.
Yeah.
Why don't we send Anwar and Jafar? Jafar can sort of like act like, you know, Anwar's his bodyguard instead of me.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. Cool.
Anyone saying no?
Yeah.
James, anyone disagreeing?
James has just said he doesn't mind if we all go, if you all go, but he just wants to maintain the cover story. But you all right with just them going? You can nod. Yeah. Okay. Right.
Sorry, before I go, money on us. Are we going to? Is the plan at this jewelry store to buy some jewels, and maybe use it as a cover to get in?
You could try that. I mean, Yodfa's got the residence there, but he's got a residence, or Yodfa's residence, you've been told, is at Sakina Falls.
Just thinking if...
Down to you, you certainly could buy gems at the... there. At the souk.
Okay. Alright. Just wondered if anyone else had any thoughts on that.
Problem is, whatever money we put together, we're not going to be able to buy the kind of gems that Yodfa is probably going to go for. So we're going to have to bluff it.
Okay.
That's like a job.
Disagree with me?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
So I would suggest that Jafar go,
Get something that we can pretend is better than it is.
Yeah. You don't have to show them anything. You just have to say, look, I'm considering making a very large purchase. Hmm. In fact, we could play along a bit more to this. If Jafar goes with Anwar, they could claim they're representing someone else. Then the rest... Then if we get the meeting at the residence, the rest of us can show up and someone else can be the main person that...
Oh, yeah. And then someone else sneak off and grab the book.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, that gives an excuse for the entire group to be there.
Be there, yeah. That is a wonderful... Yeah, okay, cool. Let's do that.
Yep.
Remember that, Louis. XP points here.
No. I'm listening. I like it.
Okay, but it's going to be down to Jafar selling it.
Keeping his shirt on.
I'm sure Jafar can do that. Yeah, he'll sell the shirt off his back. It's not a problem.
Right, well, in which case, I think the rest of us just take our leave. In fact, what I would suggest is... maybe me and James go surfing the market, not the jewellery market, but well away from that. We just go and, you know, pick a bazaar and go and wander around it for a little while, see if we can find out anything about Yodford just through the rumour mill.
Okay.
Charlie's character as well.
Yeah.
There's the fabric market, which you've already gone to.
Yeah.
You could go somewhere else if you want to suggest somewhere else that that you think you'd like to go.
Is there a food market?
There is a food market. The moment you said, is there a food market, there was a food market.
Right.
No, but what? We could go for a coffee in a food market. We went before, didn't we?
Yeah. And we could sort of like just circulate, see if we could hear any rumours about Yodfer.
Sit down, have a coffee, have a listen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or a tea, should I say?
Right. I'm just waiting. I can hear James typing. Could maybe look for some fabrics or something to make him or any of you look honourable in appearance. Obviously, aside from the particularly nice turban, which he's wearing. You could go to the fabric market. There is a food market, which is this side of the main river.
Well, how about this, Louis? How about if we just cruise the markets? We will cruise around the markets just listening for rumours. If we kind of hear someone talking about Yodfer, then we'll stop and listen.
Okay. Stop and rummage around the stall. Yeah.
You ask. Are you looking to ask any questions about Yodfer while you're about?
I want to hear if there's any particularly interesting conversations going on.
Okay.
And then I might stop and listen. But if it's just sort of like, you know, normal sort of rumours, like Yodfer spent, you know, 1,000 gold on this the other day, kind of thing. If it's rumours like that, then I'm not so interested. If it's something kind of interesting, like, I don't know, like Yodfer's responsible for the local thugs or something like that, then that's what I'm trying to keep my ear open.
Okay. There were certainly rumours in Mullock that Yodfer was maybe not the most honest of merchants, that there were possible shady dealings, and he'd certainly got stuff going on outside the city. But yeah, that's right.
I want to try and concentrate on that kind of...
Okay. In which case, I'll start with Jafar and Anwar.
Yeah.
What is Liam doing?
Liam, if you're going to open something, mute your microphone.
Sorry,
you're ripping your clothes off.
I was taking the plastic sort of covering edging off around the edge of the laptop.
It's a sellotape fetish, we know.
Well, you know.
Right.
Louis, I'm just going to grab a drink. Be back in a sec.
Yeah, no worries. Okay, Jafar, Anwar, you know the way to the palace, and the like I say, the jewellery souk is to the new sort of southwest-ish of that. It was just about where you were when you were interrupted by the shouts and the commotion yesterday. So you head back up that way. There is the general kind of bustle and hustle that you get. There's not a lot of street stalls. There's the occasional street stall selling kind of trinkets, selling various kind of jewelry made from wood or made from clay. But they're kind of on the outskirts of the main souk. When you get into the souk, they are small, dedicated stalls. There's a couple of little alleyways that are looking at silver. There's some for gold. There's some for general jewellery. And there is a small area, or a reasonable sized area, set aside for gems. It's not the hugest jewellery place on the planet, and you're kind of getting the feeling that there's some okay stuff around, but it's not the most incredible collection you've ever seen in a souk. Certainly it's much smaller than some of the similar places in somewhere like Mulut.
Right.
So, where would you like to go? What would you like to do?
Right. The bloke, I can't remember his name now, who was the guy called?
Jodfer.
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 Does he own a shop here? We know he's a pure merchant, but does he actually trade here?
You could ask around.
I would like to ask around.
Okay, where are you planning on asking? What kind of, are you going to go?
Most respectable looking bloke I can see. I don't want to talk to a riffraff, like, you know, a little.
You don't.
Okay, so you're going to have a good look around, look for somebody who looks, who looks very respectable, yeah. Which you find fairly quickly, and okay, so there's a guy there with two Mamluk bodyguards making a very purposeful way through the market towards he obviously knows where he's going, and he looks like he's going towards the jewelry centre. Which is kind of the hub. It's kind of the hub. The hub is where the jewellery place is, and then there's an area off that for gems, and there's an area off that for gold, and an area off that for silver, and then kind of various different kind of bits and pieces around there. So okay, so yeah, there's this tall guy, kafir, but extremely high quality kind of silken kafir and robes. Two Mamluks of the respected with him, both of whom are initiates. So they are they're a rank lower than Anwar, but they're fairly big guys. They're not quite as big as Anwar, but they're fairly big guys.
Well, I'd like to say, excuse me, do you know where one might be able to find Jodfer? What's his name? I've forgotten it again.
Jodfer.
Jodfer. Where one might be able to find Jodfer.
Okay.
Good
make a diplomacy check.
Let me just get my character sheet. Um, That work?
Ah, okay, and 11.
Plus? 6.
Plus 6, so 17. Yeah. Okay, you stop him. He's quite, he's a little startled that you approached him. But you explain that you're looking for a jewelry store run by Yodfa. He seems a little perplexed and says, "Well, that is not a jewelry store that I know. Is it jewelry that he sells, or gems, or gold, or?"
I was given to understand that he was a major gem merchant in these parts.
Ah, you see, I do not buy gems. I buy complete jewelry. I am here for something for my wife, so I am afraid I cannot help you in that.
I'm sorry, sir. A man of your stature, I should have guessed that he wouldn't. Do you know who I might be able to ask to find such information?
Well, the gem quarter is just along there. You're very close to it. I imagine any of the stall owners would be able to tell you where Yodfa, I believe he said his name was if he has a stall there, they should know. They should be able to tell you.
Okay. Well, thank you, good sir. So I doff my turban to him. I suppose we should head off to the gem stores, gem. the gem quarter, then, to go and ask around there.
Okay. The gem quarter is a particular couple of alleys. You're gonna pick a stall at random.
Yeah, you know, a decent-looking one. And just ask pretty much the same thing. Do you know where I can find Yodfa?
Okay. You find a stall. The because you've approached through the jewellery district. As you cross from the arches from the jewellery hub into the street of the gem merchants. You kind of get the feeling that the stalls that are closest to the jewellery area are the more upmarket ones, and the further out you get, the not the less salubrious they are, but the smaller guys dealing with the lesser merchandise are at the far end. So you kind of look around and pick a stall pick a shop at random and walk in. It's quite small and it's quite sparse. There is a counter, and behind that there are a couple of kind of very obvious set pieces. But generally, you kind of get the feeling that the place is it's not got like gems out on display. So the guy behind the counter. Small little tight black beard, he said, sort of looks you over and kind of maybe isn't entirely convinced, but the sight of you with a Mamluk definitely kind of pushes the edge, and you can kind of see him make the decision that this is probably worth doing. So he says to you, "Ah, you, yes, sir. What can I do for you? What are you looking for today?"
I'm looking for Yodfa.
Molly, I think that's you.
Yes, it is, but my mic was off, so I don't know how that noise is. That's a bit odd.
Starting a circular saw?
No.
Okay.
Polishing his camel. Go on.
Right. Okay. Sorry, Liam. Say again.
Same question again. I'm looking for a merchant called Yodfar. I'm told he operates in this vicinity.
Roll me diplomacy check.
Nine plus six, was it? Yeah,
15. Okay, the guy's face registers a kind of... He's trying to hide a certain level of distaste. And he says, I am afraid, sir, I do not believe that Yodfer owns a shop in this in the city of Simbaya. I believe you may want to visit Muluk if you really wish to trade with him. Was there anything particular that you wanted from him?
Well, I actually am a proxy of someone else. Me and my man here, we've been sent to try and locate him because our client is very particular in his taste and really is quite keen to find Yodfer himself.
Okay, Ollie, I'm going to mute you for a minute, I think. That's... No, it's not. It's gone again. We'll see what happens. Something's not well there. Okay. Are you... has your master already commenced business with Yodfer?
I'm told very little about what he actually... does. All I know is that he's heard the name of Yodfer. I believe he's well acquainted with him, but I don't know whether they've actually commenced business. But all I've been told to do is to try and find him.
If you particularly wish to see Yodfer, I would suggest you are in the wrong place. I do not believe that any in Simbaya trade specifically with him. He certainly doesn't own a store here. To be honest, it is a name that I am familiar with. I am like your humble servant, but I would suggest perhaps caution if you have not already started business with Yodfer.
Okay.
But I will not pry further. We stock a wide variety of jewelry and gems, and if there is anything that your master particularly wants, I am sure we can get that for him at a very reasonable price, and without complications.
All right. Can I go ask another storeholder what, not whether Yodfer's about, but what they've heard of Yodfer? You're sort of in a chappy, matey kind of... you seem like an honest chap. What do you think of Yodfer?
Okay. Roll me a sense motive check. Those dice are just getting lower and lower every time you roll them, aren't they?
Yeah.
If I keep this going, you're going to keep learning less and less and less as the evening goes on.
Sense motive is based on wisdom, isn't it?
Yes.
I've got a minus two for wisdom.
Oh, no, I've just been watching the dice rolls come down. Okay, you have a feeling that the merchant was not very happy to hear Yodfer's name, we'll say that, and was possibly trying to warn you against doing business with him, but you're not quite sure. Okay, so you're going to stay at this end of the street, go down the other end of the street?
Go down the other end of the street, where they all seem a bit more a bit, yeah.
More kind of, I still jewelry, still gems, but the smaller gems, the stuff used for making cheaper jewelry, perhaps. Okay, right. You find a suitable stall and walk in. roll me another diplomacy check. You're lucky in this.
Oh, hang on. Yeah.
Like I said, you got another five rolls before you hit Charlie. Yeah. Okay, so you walk in and say you've heard things about Jodfer, but you know what do they know about him?
Yeah.
Okay, the guy kind of looks a bit looks around a little cautiously. And says to you, here in Symbaya, we do not deal with Jodfer, if I am honest, sir. I do not wish to speak ill of him. I do not know him personally. I know that for some reason there are caravans that have something to do with him that pass beyond Symbaya up to the Salik Falls. Sakina Falls, but we're never quite sure why. There's nothing at Sakina Falls. I don't understand why where those caravans come from or why they're going there. But yeah, we don't deal with them. But we do have excellent merchandise, and he tries to get you interested in some of the gems.
While I'm here, I'm assuming the stuff he's selling is quite cheap and quite naff.
Yeah, I mean he is selling just the cut gems. So he's not selling whole jewellery. He's just selling the cut gems. But yeah, they'd be kind of the small pieces that you might embed into rings or into things just to make them look a bit sparkly. Yeah. You know, slightly flawed gems or gems that maybe haven't been cut so well or very small pieces, that kind of stuff.
What I'm after is basically bulk that I can wave at a guard and say, I'm here with these, you know, just some crap.
You want cubic zirconia, finest,
yeah,
cubic
that
zirconia.
That is precisely what I want, yeah.
In a large bag that you can pretend is...
something that is not. That's what I'm looking for. Can I ask him where I'm best off finding some... Well, what it is, right, is I tell him that I'm trying to impress this female, and she's a gem merchant, but to get to her, I need to get past her guards. So what I need is some bags that are going to impress, some stuff that's going to impress her guards, which will get me an in so I can start talking to her, because that's what I'm after. So where would he recommend I buy that sort of thing?
Ah, my friend. For love... What can we do? What must we do? I could, I don't know, perhaps suggest some agate. This can look suitably impressive if it is cut well without costing so much money. I have some gems of agate that I could let you have for maybe 10 gold per gem. There are some slightly less well cut pieces. May get you past a guard for 5. I could let you have them for 5. But what are we doing?
Excellent.
No, my friend. I try to do you a favour. Five gold.
5 gold?
Ah, 5 gold.
What did you say they were called?
This is called agate.
Agate?
Cyclops agate. He shuffles about underneath the counter and he pulls out a couple of gems, sort of about that kind of size, and they're translucent, almost transparent, with circles of grey and white, and brown and blue and green in them. But they're quite nice.
How much would the stall next door offer me, like get me to pay for the same amount? I'll ask him.
I cannot see that he would do you for a better price than I can manage.
Okay, well, I'll go ask him.
Do you? Very well, my friend. Very well, my friend. Five gold for agate is a good price.
For how much, sir?
That per gem, sir. Per gem.
I thought this was meant to be nath.
It's still a gem.
Yeah, but it doesn't say it's very good.
Have you got a praise skill?
Almost certainly not.
It probably doesn't come under bardic knowledge.
Yes, I do. One. I've got one in it.
Roll me an appraise skill.
Eight.
You have no idea. You really genuinely have no idea. Okay. You could, but yeah.
With this knowledge, could I go back and talk to the party and try and find them in whatever weird food bazaar they're in and ask what they think and whether it's worth it or whether just to get one and have a pouch full of sand that we can pretend is...
Okay. All right. Let me cut across to now, Simon. You were saying, was it all of the rest of the party were going with you just for a general mooch around?
Yeah, we're just generally mooching around, just basically to hear whatever rumours there are out there about Yahood or whatever. His
okay,
name
so was. Kind of buying coffee. Getting sitting in roadside cafes or the kind of cafes in the souks, listening to what's going on and just trying to absorb. Okay, you don't really hear very much about Yodfa. In fact, you hear almost nothing at all about him. There is a discussion that you hear about a strange caravan, which is once again has been seen going beyond the city towards Sakina Falls, and the two men that are discussing it are saying they cannot imagine why caravans occasionally go that way because there's nothing there. But you hear a rumor about a caravan that's going up to Sakina Falls for some reason, but you don't.
Is there
hear
a main area where caravans are put together, with you know, where they buy their tack and stuff like that, or riding harness for camels and stuff?
They would actually, funnily enough, they would stay at the caravanserai which you've been staying at.
Okay, so I think we should have a mooch around the caravan Sapphira to see if your food is getting his people from there or if he's employing them separately.
Okay.
And see if we can get an idea of what those caravans are carrying.
Yeah, that sounds like a good plan. Okay, so you guys kind of are the rest of you guys going with Yazeed, or are you going to stay and mooch where you are? You can go back to the.
I think we'll have a mooch over with him towards the caravan. See what's going on.
Okay. So you head back to where you've been staying, and go back to the.
You stopped.
Sorry. I was distracted by what's in the chat, and I'm trying to work out exactly what he means. Okay, so yeah, you get back to the caravanserai, and Nabil goes up for a lie down and a rest in the room that you booked. He's feeling a little weak. Sorry, I will just point out that Nabil lost 2 hit points overnight, because that was the deal that he made with Sagira. So he's got a permanent loss of 2 hit points, and as long as he maintains his relationship with Sagira. Okay, so you get back there. Ollie, do you want to make me a just trying to think what kind of roll it would be. It's basically a blind luck roll, so just roll me a d20, and if you've got wisdom, then give me your wisdom modifier to it.
Okay.
Okay. 18 was good. 18 was what you wanted.
I'm impressed.
Okay, so, right. So, yeah, I was just to find out how long it was going to be before you twigged that there was that the best bet was probably to go back to the caravanserai and just wait for them to come there. You get to the caravanserai, and I believe, were you saying going to the stables?
Yeah, just kind of sort of like, you know, someone's got to provide them with their hard tack, someone's got to provide them with their guards. So maybe sort of like, Ollie, if you go and have a look at the, go and wander around the guard area to see if there's any rumours about caravans going up to Sakina Falls, was it?
Sakina Falls.
And I'll go and have a mooch around the bit that provides tack or the equivalent for it for camels.
So Ollie, you go and talk to some of the guards. Some of the larger caravans would employ Mamluks either as their guards, or more often kind of they'd employ a couple of Mamluks to look after kind of local people, so that they pick people as guards and then have Mamluks running those guards and controlling those guards. You find a group of guys. Can you roll me a diplomacy check?
I'm pretty sure this is a negative. Yep, minus 2.
So if you manage a good dice roll like you did last time, it'll be fine.
Yeah. Ten
total.
Yeah.
Get a bonus for it being with other people, right?
I'm capable of setting the DC. Just chill. Have I killed you in a dark alley yet?
Not for lack of trying.
Right. You they're not exactly the camaraderie's a bit thin on the ground. When you start talking about the caravan routes and where the caravan routes are going and whether or not they see any going further up the trail. And a couple of the guys say, you know, from Symbia is sometimes used, sometimes caravans just go from Symbia. More often they go from Muluk, and they go up the river and they get to Symbia, use that as a stop-off point, use that as somewhere to pick up final supplies, etc. So maybe beef up the guards there. And then they tend to split out away from the river, because as you go up, you just get to Sakina Falls. There's nothing up at Sakina Falls to send things up to. When you kind of mention Sakina Falls, they say, yeah, it's weird. Occasionally they see caravans that either seem to be coming that way or going that way. They haven't worked out. Nobody's kind of quite worked out. Just seems a bit strange. And the more they think about it, the more perplexed they are. Certainly they've never been hired to guard the caravans, but the caravans that do go up there are fairly well protected. They've quite often got a kind of dwarven merchant leading them. They have they have you know, anything up to kind of a dozen guards with them, and they're just a mule train, really. There aren't camels, there aren't carts. It's just kind of half a dozen mules. So yeah, everybody's a bit about where it's come from, but they don't really think too much about it. Not my business. I'm not sticking my nose in. Just trying to get on a decent caravan that doesn't get raided or attacked, off to a different city, or occasionally they get asked to go to Mulloch from here, but not really. Yeah, Simon. So you go and start up a conversation with the guys looking after the camels, and I mean, they've got your donkeys there at the moment. Are they donkeys or were they mules?
I think some of them mules, but I definitely had a camel.
Aha. Okay. So yeah. So you kind of go to check on the animals, and have a chat with them. So what are you sort of inquiring about? The same kind of thing, really. Caravans that are leaving from here or stopping here on the way to Sakina.
Yes.
Roll me a diplomacy check. It can't, well, I was going to say it can't hurt. It could hurt. That doesn't look like it's going to hurt, though.
That's an 18, and I've got a diplomacy of 0.
So okay. 18. Okay. Yeah, they're a bit friendlier with you. They're looking after your animals. They're perfectly happy to talk. But the subject of caravans to Sakina, they just sort of look at you and say, "Why would anybody take a caravan to Sakina? It's less than a day away, and there isn't really anything there."
Well, I was more interested in. I know there's a caravan that goes that way. I was more interested in what it was carrying, because obviously, if there's a caravan going that way, there must be some trade. So therefore, it would be interesting to know what they're trading out there.
The guy says, "Yeah, it's funny you say that. Occasionally, we hear of a mule train that goes either way, but he never seems to stop. It always seems to go straight through to Mulloch. I don't know.
You don't provide any of the tack or harnesses for the animal, for the animals. You don't provide any care for the animals they've got with them.
No. We did have more. Might have been a year ago, 18 months. We had somebody came in and bought some mule tacks and some bits and pieces. I seem to remember. No. I think we had somebody bought some tack from us, but there's a lot of tack. We never see any of their animals. It is funny. You would have thought Sakina to Mulloch. Although they must come from further than Sakina. There's nothing at Sakina. You come from Sakina. It's pretty funny.
Sakina at all? Does someone live there?
No, just waterfall.
Okay, I'll thank them very much and tip them a silver or something for looking after the animals.
It's the back cave.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah, you kind of get through that conversation, and pretty much immediately Actually, no, Anwar's already come back, hasn't he? Yeah. So, yeah, you get through that conversation, and I'll let you guys discuss.
It sounds very strange coming back from a waterfall.
I think we just go up there. I think we just go up there.
Go and investigate.
Stopping us going, you just go up to have a look.
Yeah.
It sounds like this caravan that goes up to Sakina is very exclusive. So I don't think we're going to find anyone, James. I think we just go and have a look.
Yeah.
Less than a day's journey. It's about a day's journey, so we can wander up there and wander back again.
If we've got enough supplies, just make sure we take a bit of food and water with us, and we're done.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. James has said, can you guys find somebody who's actually been up to Sakina?
How do you mean a guide? Ah.
Well, either a guide or I think you just mean somebody that would. Yeah, no, just
a caravan buddy.
Well, we certainly could do that. I don't see any reason why we can't. What sort of time of day is it, Louis? Is it sort of like mid-morning?
Yeah, I'd say mid-morning.
I would suggest we spend the rest of the day seeing who has been up to the area, like a guide or something like that, and then we'll go in the morning.
Okay.
A day's rest, as it were.
You want to ask around at the caravanserai again?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. You ask. You ask around at the caravanserai. I'm desperately trying to think whether or not I gave the guy who runs the caravanserai a name 3 sessions ago when you first got here. But if I did, then I apologise because he's now called Asim. Asim. Yes, actually. Wait a moment. Let me find a different name. Oh, no, Asim's all right. You're thinking of Aziz.
It's not Asim O2, is it?
Asim. Asim, who you mentioned to him, you know, you're interested in going and having a look at Sakina Falls. You do get the same kind of slightly puzzled, bemused look where he says, Sakina, very pretty. Been there once or twice. It's a nice thing to look at. What are you hoping to find there? Oh, Simon's gone all quiet. Would anybody else like to...
Is
there
anything
of special interest anyway?
Are we going to go along the lines of, well, we're traveling professors, and we're doing a geological study, and you know, we want someone that's been there before to, you know, really point us in the way of the best minerals.
Yeah, and we wouldn't want to get lost as well, so we're
not
really a guide.
We are looking for minerals.
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay. I don't know about minerals. As I say, it is quite pretty. Yeah, you don't need a guide. Sakina's dead easy to find. You follow up the road becomes a track. You follow up the track becomes narrower. When you get to the raging torrent of water, you're at Sakina. I don't know that you'll find anything there, but if you've come all the way from Muluk...
I think we should go on our own without a guide.
If you leave early tomorrow, you could probably make it there and back in a day. Might be pushing it. But it's not a dangerous place. It doesn't really go anywhere, so there aren't really bandits there. Most of the caravans go out from the river, not up the river. But as I say, it's a pretty place. I've been there 2, maybe 3 times. Very impressive waterfall.
Okay, I think I suggest we go without a guide.
Yeah.
That way we can do what we like without being watched as well, hopefully.
Yeah.
Yep, James agrees.
He does.
Simon agrees.
Okay.
Absence makes the heart grow fondly.
So you're going to spend another night at the caravanserai, another night in Muluk.
Yep. And then we'll head off first thing in the morning, see if we can do a day trip.
Okay. Okay, so yeah, you spend another comfortable night in Simbaya. I'll say this, the city's quite nice. The food in the caravanserai is hearty but plain. It's good stuff. You bed down for the night, have a word with the guys, and say you're going to get up first thing in the morning.
Do we have to prepare our transport?
Sorry?
Have we reorganised our transport ready for the morning? What? Our cart?
You've got a cart, two donkeys, and a camel. Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah.
So they'll all be ready in the morning as well.
Okay. So you have a word. Who is likely to be, out of the group, the first one to go down to start the check on the animals in the following morning?
After I've done my morning prayer, maybe, but I don't know I'll be first.
Yeah, actually, at this point, it wouldn't be you or Nabil. Most likely you'd be up and about early because you'd be meditating. Nabil would be reading his spell book.
Yep, playing with his turban, yep.
Who owns the camel?
Simon,
is it Aziz?
Aziz. Yazid owns the camel. Okay, so I'll hang on. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Right. The next morning. So you guys sleep well, get up, and before breakfast. Anwar decides he's going to wander down, just check the animals are ready before you guys head off. As he gets into the passageway that leads round to the where the animals are kept, he can hear in he can hear the guys talking, and just as he gets to the door, he catches the phrase. Yeah, Sakina. Well, they'll be back. We get them for tonight. We get them for tomorrow. Sakina? And then they hear him coming and busy themselves preparing the animals. And, when Anwar turns up, the animals are pretty much ready to go. So having checked that... Anwar goes back to you have breakfast, and you're free to go and hit the road.
Have we got enough water and everything loaded in the wagon or cart?
Yeah,
I mean, desert,
you know. No, it's not. You're in a river valley. You're in a river valley. The river runs. I mean, runs from beyond Sakina, but there are the falls at Sakina, and it runs down the river. So you're actually in quite a lush valley. You've gone past the indigo fields, which are used for the dyes that they for the purple dyes at Muluk. And
crazy enough,
yeah, there are various food fields around and about dotted about. There's plenty of fields and plantations between Muluk and Sakina. Between Muluk and Simbaya. As you get outside Simbaya and start to head off, there are a couple of farms and homesteads and things, and they kind of, but within about sort of, I don't know, maybe 5 miles, 6 miles outside of Simbaya, they disappear, and you are just left with this kind of verdant, lush green, very pleasant river valley, as the river winds its way slowly up the valley.
In the valley.
We're going to keep our eye out and have a look around as we go and see if we can see other people following us or anybody about. Just a gentle, discreet look around, you know.
Oh,
look at the scenery.
Sorry, Ollie.
Sorry, I was just going to say, so are we going there with the intention of stealing the thingy, I can't remember what it is, the thing, and then coming back? Yeah, book. Or are we going, looking at what it's like, seeing what's there, then coming back, planning what we're doing, and then going again?
I think we'll scope it out and plan it from there, I think. If we think we can get away with it, then let's go for it.
Right, okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, pass ledger. Thanks, James. Okay, yeah, just odd check.
Okay. Right, so you you work your way out of town, and like I say, certainly by the time you're 10 miles outside of town, you're just in kind of there's reed beds alongside the river and some palm trees. There's the banks of the valley are quite green. There's kind of tree lines at the top. But you know that if you get more than about, I don't know, half a mile beyond the other side of that valley, it's likely to be kind of scrub, and it will gradually work out and become less visible. The track definitely becomes much, much narrower. And after you've done, I don't know, probably another couple of miles beyond the point where you got past the last farm, it starts to narrow down considerably. You are actually going to have problems getting the cart to continue to go along the track because the track is so narrow.
Oh well, we tried. Let's go back.
Can we leave Jafar looking after the cart then, while we go on?
Okay.
How far is this from the fort?
You're about 2 miles past the last farm.
Right. So.
And you probably got another. You guess you probably got about another five. Probably another 5 to 6 miles before you get to the falls.
Right. Okay.
If we can't get our car up here, how did the caravans get up along the river?
Well, the caravan, when they were talking about the caravans, they were talking about a mule train.
Talking about the mule train. All right.
I'm not singing.
Do we want to go back to the farm, drop the car off and take the donkeys with us as well as the camel? Not that we'll all be able to ride, but we'll be able to take it in turns.
Might as well just leave it.
And see if it's here when we come back.
What is the camel, is a mule going to be for us?
Depends what we find and decide to bring back.
Pair of jump leads and a cork.
Yeah.
That's an in-joke. Right, there is... if there's a caravan going up there today, we don't want them to suspect us, says James.
Oh, I was about to say that.
Okay. There are a few places sort of half
where
a mile.
Where can we hide their cart?
There are places, say, certainly half a mile back where you could get off the trail and you could... kind of find a way of tying up the donkey so they got something
that
to
sounds
eat.
Sounds like a good idea.
Mind you.
We don't just want to leave them because somebody will take them, I'm guessing.
Well, it's got to be said, you're a fair way from nowhere. You know,
we're somewhere.
You haven't seen another soul in the last 2 miles, and it's becoming... less well travelled, not more well travelled. But yeah, no, that's fine. So okay, so
find somewhere and hide our mules, donkeys.
You're going to have problems hiding the cart. There isn't really a lot of a lot of big bushes, or the trees that are there are mostly kind of palm type, so thin at the bottom, not a lot of foliage to get up further. So you could drive the cart off the road. Likewise, you're not really going to be able to hide the donkeys, but you can get them off the trail, and there's kind of enough grass and things for them to be able to have something to eat while you're
huddle them and tie them up. Yep.
While you're away. Okay. Right, so you leave the donkeys and that. Simon, are you going to take your camel with you or leave that here?
No, I'll leave it with the donkeys.
Okay. By this point, it's past midday. It's harder going. The weather's hotter. Anwar, what are you doing armor-wise? Because obviously you've got your armor sat in the car, covered up. You could take it with you. You could wear it now, but it's going to be really hot. Or you could kind of carry it.
I'll carry it, but yeah, I'm not going to wear it.
Okay. Right, so yeah, you wind your way on. It is several more miles. It does take some time. The path gets a lot narrower, leaving the camel behind was definitely a good move. You'd have had problems getting a camel up here. You can see where the mule train could get down here, and you can see markings of where kind of obviously there have been mules coming this way. Does anybody have a knowledge nature or a survival skill?
I've got knowledge nature. I've got every knowledge.
Okay.
I've got one survival skill.
Okay, do you guys want to roll me...
Go on.
Yeah, and James has got nature as well. Right, do you want to... roll me appropriate rolls and let me know what you got?
I'm dead. 11.
Okay, so you got 14.
Yes.
11.
This is going to be interesting because James is trying the dice app, but I don't think it's going to show up
with his picture up.
Yeah, I don't think it does.
Right. James with his knowledge nature 9 got a 12 in total.
Yep.
Okay, so we got, was that a 10, 12...
11.
Okay.
14. I got 14.
Okay, 14. Right, there's definitely been traffic up and down here. It's been mules. It's a bit difficult to tell quite how recently, but you kind of get the feeling it hasn't been kind of the last day or two, certainly, that there was last traffic up and down here. But as I say, it gets narrower. It winds up. The river canyon gets wider. It's still, the river at this point is 30, 40 feet across. So I realize I have any map. Right. Yeah. The river is kind of a good 30, 40 feet across. But it's the river canyon is considerably wider than that. You know, it's probably 100, 200 feet across, and the path that you are on is leading up the side of the canyon, so that the canyon is starting to drop away below you, and as you round a slight bend to the right, you start to hear this kind of distant thunder, I suppose you'd call it, the river widens quite suddenly, kind of widens. It's not square edged, but it kind of widens out until as you come round the corner, you see it's now filling the whole 200 feet of the canyon, you continue, and there's a large rock wall that's curving around Damlight. And as you continue round, suddenly you catch sight of the falls. And the falls are, I don't know, probably only about 20, 30 feet wide. But they're kind of a good, I don't know, 100, 120 foot of drop. So they are really spectacular, and the clouds and steaming water vapor is boiling up where it pounds into the lake at the bottom. I'm gonna say Nabil again. Can you roll me a nature check? Liam, can you roll me a nature check? Can Jafar roll a nature check? I don't know, Simon, have you got knowledge nature?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Is Liam still there?
Yeah. 15 in total.
15 in total, okay. And Nabil gets a 26. Okay. Both of you spot that this is a natural dam. But what Nabil notices is that as you look up the trail, like I say, there is this huge rock wall in front of you. And off on your right, and the trail that you're on seems to lead up almost to the very falls themselves. Most of the way up the falls, there are the falls. Sort of, I don't know, 70 feet to there, to your left as you're looking at it, there is a further point which looks like it's been wet. It looks vaguely eroded. You'd almost say it was a dried up waterfall, except for the fact that in the place where the dried up waterfall would be, there is, it looks like it has in the recent past been very wet, but it's not wet at the moment. So that's something that that Nabil notices.
They turned off the waterfall.
And I don't know if Nabil's going to point that out to... So Nabil points that out, and certainly, Jafar, you can, at the moment he points it out to you, you can see exactly what he means. It's like there's a double waterfall, but one of them is missing. One of them has no water. Like I say, the canyon continues leading up. The bank by the side of you is steep with bushes and scrub. Below you is likewise steep with bushes and scrub before it plunges into the lake. But this it looks very much as if it just goes straight up and actually stops at the waterfall.
Okay. I think we probably should go and have a look at that area then.
Yeah. Keep going, but look out for extra trails and bits that are out of the ordinary.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so you continue up the trail. There are no other side trails off. There is just this big steep bank. I mean, it's not vertical, but it's pretty steep. For Charlie and for James, if you were to, actually possibly for Ollie, if you were to think about the valley that leads down from the top of Holmbury Hill, the really steep bit,
We're traversing a steep cliff.
Yeah, but it's that kind of steepness. And like I say, there are bushes and there's shrub there, but there aren't any other trails leading off it. You continue up, and the trail doesn't luckily get any narrower than it is. You can definitely see why anybody coming this way would want mules rather than anything else. The trail leads up to this immense rock wall and starts to move around it, and the roar of the waterfall is deafening. But when you start to, you get up to the point where the trail turns across what is now a pretty much a vertical surface. You feel the spray in the air before you get within 50 foot of the waterfall, and it is just thundering down the hill, huge and vast, as powerful as nature can possibly be. And the trail just leads straight into the waterfall. It goes along the side and just disappears into this pouring vast torrent of water.
Can we see any how can I put it, any marks in the rock or anything else, or is it just a sheer wall?
It's a sheer wall on your right. You can search it if you want to.
Would be a good idea if somebody's got a good search skill. That's some way of searching it.
Oh, Simon dropped.
Yawn too wide. Get on his bandwidth. So there he is. So let's search this wall and see if we can find anything. What do we need to search? A wall.
Okay.
Are we all searching?
Yes.
Right.
Not that wall. I'm going to search a wall. Come on. So are we rolling to search or are we just searching?
If a couple of people with decently high roll skills want to search, I'll give the
roll skills.
Perception skills want to search. I'll if we say who's got good, I'm guessing no.
I've got three.
You've got three. Who else has got perception that's reasonably high?
I've got seven.
Okay. What's Jafar got? Now is he muted? Ah, there we go.
I don't think it's high. Percept three.
Based on wisdom. Okay. Simon, if you roll, and I'll give you bonuses for the fact that everybody else is looking with you.
Okay. 14 plus 7 is 21.
Okay. You scour the whole bunch of you scour this. You are as positive as you can be that there is no opening. There are still, I mean, it's difficult to tell because of the water, but there are still tracks even on this part of the trail. Why anybody would bring a mule this close to the waterfall and how they'd get the mule back, it just doesn't quite make sense.
If we backtrack along the trail, can we go along the top above the waterfall? Because we're walking along in the waterfall sort of area. Can we go along the top to where the water's going over the edge?
Okay, Louis.
Yeah?
I'm going to call my Jen.
Okay.
And I'm going to ask him to go and find a spell for me.
Okay.
First level spell.
Yep.
Detect secret doors.
Detect secret doors. Okay. Yes.
I should have. I think it's 60% chance of getting that. Or is it 60? Okay. I'm level 2. It's a first level spell. So a 77% chance of getting it.
Okay, can you define me? Can you read me the spell description?
Certainly.
Oh, there we go. Forgot my Pathfinder book. So, what was it? Detect secret doors.
I think that's what it's called. Yeah, I'll just get it exactly right.
Keep running into points where I know the name of a spell in D&D and it's called something different. Got it. Detect secret doors.
Yeah.
Cone-shaped emanation, 60 foot, apartments, caches, and so forth. Okay. Right. The did we come up with a name for your Your gen in the room? No? No. We decided not to go with Warwick.
Yes.
Okay. I think that's probably a wise move. Okay, right. So you do detect secret doors.
Have you got the description for it, Louis?
I have the exact description. Okay. As the game goes on, you'll work out why I'm pondering what to tell you with that. So, yeah, you send your gen off, and he comes back successfully with a tablet. You read it and you focus, and you can feel the area in front of you, and you probe it with your mind. And what you what do the secret doors look like when you if the spell works? What's the secret door going to look like?
I think it really just outlines a door in a glow.
Okay. So
it says here if you concentrate for a number of rounds, you get different results. So on the first round, you just know whether or not there's one there.
Yeah.
On the second round, you know the number of secret doors and the location of each.
Right.
If an aura is outside your line of sight, then you discern its direction, but not its exact location.
Okay.
Each additional round after that, the mechanism or trigger for one particular secret portal, closely examined by you. Each round you can turn to detect secret doors in a new area. The spell can penetrate barriers, but 1 foot of stone, 1 inch of common metal, or a thin sheet of lead, 3 feet of wood or dirt blocks it.
Okay. Right. As you cast the spell, you close your eyes and you feel with your mind going out. And something is pinpointed, and you open your eyes, and it's because of the angle that you're at, it's slightly difficult to tell, but there is definitely a hidden door. It appears to be around halfway along the face of the waterfall, so it is completely covered. If the waterfall is kind of 30 feet wide, it's in the middle of that. At the level of the rock shelf that you're on. So you can see it, and you know it's there, but it's 15 foot inside this thundering wall of water. When I say wall, I mean wall.
Okay.
Okay, so I think Ollie was quite quiet, but I think what Ollie was saying is it's like the Batcave.
Yeah.
James is saying someone should try going under the waterfall to see if there is a path, attach a rope to them.
That's a lot of water falling down, though, on top of someone.
And it looks like you can divert the water somehow.
Yeah. I'm beginning to think a detect magic may find us a bit more.
Yeah.
Do you want to do it, James, or do you want me to?
Do you want to do detect magic? He's just checking to make sure he's got his cantrip, isn't it?
Yes.
He doesn't have it, so it looks like Yazid's casting it.
Right, I shall wander off and send my gen away. I think we decided I could just cantrips.
You could do cantrips, but I think you have to decide which ones you want for that day.
Okay.
So we treat... mechanically, you treat cantrips like you treat cantrips if you were a wizard.
Yeah, okay. But detect magic then.
Yeah, okay. Again, you pause and you focus and...
Oh, bugger, no, sorry, Louis, can I change my mind?
Go on.
I want to carry on concentrating with the detect secret door spell, because that will show me opening mechanisms.
Okay.
Because if you remember, if I spend additional rounds actually
studying
a door.
I'm not being awkward. I just want to check exactly what...
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Detect secret doors.
Can I just check with Jafar and see if we're standing in the place that gets wet if somebody trips it?
No,
or
you're not.
You're standing on the other. No.
You're that's stood right. on one end of the on one end of this huge rock wall. Then there's yep. the wall. Then there's a big gap. Then there's the other place that looked like it should be a waterfall. There okay. is.
Just checking.
Right, I am going to say that as much as you focus, you cannot find a trigger for this door. It is a secret door, but there doesn't appear to be a trigger for it.
Okay, detect magic then.
Okay, detect magic does not reveal any kind of magic in the waterfall or on the face of the waterfall. Actually, it Oh, this is really tricky. I hadn't thought about this.
The first round, presence or absence of a magical aura.
No. I get detect magic. It's with this particular thing. There is a magical effect. I will tell you that much. Okay, what I'm going to say is that there is some kind of spell cast on the wall, pretty much above where you are. Now, you want to know the aura of that, which is what I'm racking my brain to desperately think.
So, can I touch Simon with a bit of luck?
No, all that's going to do is give him a... That basically gives him an option to re-roll. Well, this isn't roll-related.
Okay.
I don't know what... I don't know. The problem is I don't know what kind of magic this is. I know that it's magic, but I could not tell you what kind of magic it is. But there is a... there is a spell that has been cast on the wall just above where you are.
Will you give me a knowledge arcana roll?
Go on.
See if I can tell what the spell is.
Go for it.
Oops, hang on, let me clear that. I think it was a 7, wasn't it?
It was.
Well, now we'll go with a 7. 7 plus... By the time you put bonuses
on that...
10. 17.
17? Okay.
In total.
You've got Nabil with you. Okay. This is a... It's like a trigger. Hell, you've tried everything possible. I'll give you what you could find out. So this is a trigger. This is a way of doing something. And the chances are it's not. If you have a wand, say, or a magical item, quite often when you have a magical item, it registers the type of spell of that magical item, but you have to trigger that magical item, and quite often that is done with a sound or with a word. This is the trigger portion of a spell. So what you have is, and it is high level magic, it is what you're looking at is big, it's not kind of beginner level, but it's the patch of the wall above where you are is a trigger mechanism for something. So if you say the appropriate word, something will happen, it will trigger something. You don't know what that word is, and you're not
what
into
language?
What's going to happen, yeah. Or what language?
Open sesame.
and you don't know what it's going to do. But that's what this part of the wall does.
Okay. So, we want to try Open Sesame, do we?
Yeah, I think Liam wants to try Speak, Friend, and Enter, and you want to try Open Sesame.
I want to try it in Madani. The DM is brilliant.
Okay, so you try a couple of different things. You try Open Sesame. You try Open. You try Speak, Friend, and Enter. You try Friend. None of these are working.
So would James Nabil and his brand new friend of the Turban be any use to us at this point?
You want to ask Sagira?
Yeah. We can get Nabil to ask Sagira if she's got any ideas. I can do it telepathically, we don't need to hear. It's all right.
Sagira says that, there are various ways of doing that. Trying to break one of these, trying to work out what it is really, really difficult. Incredibly hard. And with the power of the magic that Yazid has described on the wall, she says to Nabil that there is almost you would need a very, very high level mage to try and work out what it is. What you either need to find the word, or find somebody who knows the word or the phrase, and it would be very, very difficult to break it and divine it.
Louis, is there somewhere we can sell where we can observe the waterfall but we can't be observed?
There's various scrubland on there's various kind of bushes and stuff on the slopes, so you could end up there. You could try and climb the slope and get up to the top. At this point, you're quite a way above the waterfall. It would be difficult to hear if somebody said something where you are now. If you were up on the top of the waterfall, or if you were very close by, it would be difficult. But there are bushes. Could you hide in the bushes? If you were careful, you could maybe hide in the bushes on the side of the slope.
One of us, or all of us.
One or two at most out of four.
The more of you that are hiding, the more... Yeah.
Just said it's possible for you to hide. You weren't, yeah. You meant one person.
Just out of interest, Louis, can we get behind the waterfall without actually having the water fall on us?
No, it is against the wall of the rock. Or at least it appears to be.
Okay, well, my plan here is to sit and wait until someone shows up. What do we think?
Would it be able to have the caravan back to a base sort of thing and find out when the next caravan's coming? Now we know what we're looking for.
How fresh do the tracks look, Louis?
Not very. You try to look. I'll tell you what, I'll let... Who was it who had nature? I know Nabil had nature, and I think Jafar had nature. So Jafar and Nabil, do you want to have another look just around here and try and work out how long you think it's been since anything came this way?
Yes, I would like to do that.
How many times did you have to press that button and clear it again before you unlocked your screen?
I didn't. That was honestly the first time, because if it had been a low number, I'd have said, no, Louis, I would not like to do that.
Okay, both of you have a good look at the... both of you have a good look at the tracks. The tracks are probably getting on for a week old.
If that's the case, I reckon we should hang around. So if it's been a week since they've been here, then chances are they're going to be.
Do we have any clue what the frequency of visits is? Oh, and we're talking to a caravan. They said they come through occasionally.
Good point.
The rest, but not every day or every week.
The trails look the trails, like I say, they look like they're about a week old. They do look fairly
regular.
They look like there's been regular trips. It's something that's not once in a while. It does look like it's probably fairly often. Although
so if we find somebody to hide, we could go back down the trail a bit to where we can see down the road and see them coming before we hide, before somebody goes up and hides.
Well, before we do that, I want to have another nose round the wall. Louis.
Okay.
If I put my hand out towards the water, yeah?
Yeah.
I want to see whether or not I think it's going to hurt to actually stand underneath that water. Because obviously that's a lot of water falling a long way.
I am not even going to make you roll for it. Even on a roll of one, you would... That's a lot of water. I know that James is still suggesting that somebody pushes through with a rope tied round them.
Off he goes.
Barbosa.
Let's chuck the monkey at the waterfall.
He's not looking very keen.
Who's the obvious one?
I can't.
He can hold on better than the rest of us.
No, the wall of water is huge and solid and very, very substantial. And it's buffeting against the face of the wall. You're fairly sure if you tried to step under it as it fell, it's not just the weight of the water hitting you, it's bouncing off the wall, it's hitting the wall. If you actually got to the waterfall, it would just probably sweep you away.
Okay. What about studying the wall, the driest bit of wall near to it, and I want to look to see if I can find any writing or anything on the wall.
Okay, roll me a perception check.
No. 10.
No, there's no writing on the wall.
So are we going to hide somebody here and one or two people here and then go back?
Let's see if we can go to the top of the waterfall first.
Okay.
Because somebody's going to be stopping that water coming down, so...
Yeah, I reckon we have a look at the top.
Okay. Who has the best climb skill?
Oh,
yeah. Not me.
One. I have a climb skill.
It's not a difficult climb, but it would be.
Can we do acrobatics?
Okay, sorry, can you do
acrobatics instead of climb, or is it climbing? Climbing, I've got a 6 in.
Oh, he's a man. He's our man then.
I'll give you acrobatics.
Acrobatics. I've got a 9. Climb, I've got a 6.
Anwar, what have you got for climb?
4.
Stand me up.
Okay.
Are we going to tie a rope on him or not?
Entirely down to you.
If
so
there's
a
rope,
him back down.
Then no. More importantly, I can tie it to something, and the rest of you can come up.
So, are you going to take the rope with you, or are we going to tie it to you?
I'll take a rope with me.
Righto.
Anything else?
Another would... key question. Who's got a rope I can give him?
Oh, actually, hey, wait. Sorry, Louis. At the Mage Hand is a zero-level spell, right? For a bard. Is there anything on the top we could loop it, Mage Hand, and loop it over instead of risking my precious body?
What's the range on Mage Hand?
Really, really far.
It 30 feet, if you're lucky. Because I remember a game where you guys had to climb up to the first floor in order to use it.
Yeah.
25 foot per two levels, so I've got 30 foot, yeah.
Yeah.
The crenellation thing.
No, you know what? It's obviously not going to be big enough. I'll just climb it with the rope.
Okay, if you wanted to, there's a couple of trees at the top. You could mage hand maybe to get a rope around one of them. How long's your rope?
Now you're asking. I don't even have rope. I was hoping to borrow
somebody. I know somebody has a rope.
Oh, definitely does, because we used it in the first one.
I think Charlie's got a rope.
I am looking through my pile of stuff, and
I've got silk rope, 50 foot long.
Okay, so you got 50 foot of rope. So Yazid's got 50 foot of rope.
I've got a grappling hook, I think, but other than that, no.
You can't have a grappling hook and not rope. That's well.
Well, I've got a grappling hook, so I must have rope on it.
I think we said you had rope in the first adventure.
Yeah.
I don't think you need a grappling hook with Mage Hand, but I think you could use the rope. You could use Mage Hand to get a rope up there.
In that case, I shall do that.
Okay, so... and Nabil's got a rope. So I think you tie the two pieces of rope together and you get Mage Hand to take one end up and then bring it back down so you've got... It's kind of round a tree. I'm still going to make you roll a climb check.
Okay, that's fine.
It's climb was 4 and acrobatics was 6.
No, climb was 6, acrobatic was 9.
My climb's 4, Louis.
All right, okay. Do it as a climb check. What you got?
So that's 14 at 6:20.
Okay, you scamper away up the hill. A couple of times, the little curly bits on the end of your shoes get caught, but other than that, it's fine. You get up to the top, make sure the rope's all tied off. So you're now at the top of the canyon.
Is there a obvious sort of at the top of the waterfall? Does it all look normal, or is there something a bit funny?
Okay, you're gonna walk around. Are you gonna walk around sort of towards the top of the waterfall then?
Yeah.
Okay. The top of the waterfall, the river widens considerably. There's a big head of water as it narrows for the actual fall, and the river goes back 120, 130 feet. It goes back a long way, and then what you can see is almost like a separate channel that leads down to that other bit that you noticed before. So there is a fork in the river that runs down and runs up to the edge, but only one side is full of water.
The other side, is there an obvious reason why the other side isn't full of water? Like, is it clogged up with...
When you walk up, the problem is that you're the wrong side of the water to be able to see it. But... No, from your side of the river, it just appears that the river doesn't flow down there.
Hmm.
There doesn't seem to be... There's no bank at that point that you can see. It just appears that the river continues to flow down one leg of the fork, but not the other leg of the fork.
And from the bank, I can't have a feel around on the bank just whereas it's about to, you know, the bank by the edge, there's nothing.
No. Have you got Detect Magic? Is that a bard cantrip or not?
Not one that I've got, no.
Okay.
But I could message down, because I've got message as a cantrip to Simon's character that he should detect magic up here, and he can actually whisper back to me.
Okay, he'd have to come up to do it.
Okay. Well, I'll still bardic message. I can't remember what the actual thing is.
Yeah, no, it's a message cantrip. So, yeah, Simon, you hear... I was going to say, Yusuf, my brain's gone. Jafar's voice in your ear explaining what he sees. And sorry?
How easy does the climb look?
The climb does not look... I mean, I know your character's not tremendously strong. How fits your character?
Well, I haven't got a climb skill, and I haven't got any kind of bonus.
Okay. It's not an arduous climb, and with the rope, the chances of slim, the chances of falling are very, very slim.
I'll climb up.
Roll me a climb check.
Okay.
Because I like them. that makes it. That makes it. It's like I say. It's about 30 foot. It's not a very difficult climb, but it's and with the rope there, you get to the top and stand and catch your breath, and as you turn around and look down, it is a glorious view. So do you want to wander around and cast?
Yeah.
Okay, so you wander around and cast Detect Magic. No sooner has the spell left your lips than this point behind, like sort of 100 feet up the river, lights up like the 4th of July. It is just glowing and shimmering neon. The levels of magic there are so intense that you almost have to look away from it.
So the waterfall pretty well, I'm going to guess, changes to the other path when people want to go through the door. Just a guess, but...
Okay, can I try a knowledge arcana check after studying it for a little while to see if I think I can...
You can. Simon, can you flip your headset, your mic down?
Sorry. Is that better?
Yeah.
Knowledge Arcana.
All right.
Yeah, make me a roll.
21.
This is high level magic. This is what are you particularly trying to get from it? What are you looking for?
Your mic there. All right. I think I'm trying to get the School of Magic. And any useful information I think I can get that will enable me to basically activate the spell.
I'll be honest, the problem with a School of Magic is I don't know.
High-level magic. This is...
That's weird. What are you particularly... I'm getting a real delayed loop back on my own voice every now and then. Sorry, Nabil wants to climb up, so Nabil, roll me a climb check, and yes, you can climb up. I don't know what type of magic it is. I keep thinking through the schools and just thinking, I don't know. But, yeah, it...
Okay, can I have a perception check to have a look around up there and see if there's anything else I think might be of use up there? I.e. The words written down somewhere or something stupid like that?
I would give you that off the Arcana check alone if they were there, but they're not.
No, okay.
This has been cast... Nabil scrambles up, not very elegantly, but gets up to the top.
What was the name of the guy that we're meant to be going to see again? It was Yodfa, wasn't it?
You're supposed to be seeing Yodfa, yes.
Okay. I'll try saying his name out loud.
Okay. Note that doesn't work.
It's worth a go.
The James, give me an Arcana check. Okay. On a 22, there's a reason why he would know this and you wouldn't. Obviously, it is a huge magic. Years ago, and he's heard stories of this because he's native to Muluk. There was a very famous water mage named Zarastro, and he is the one name that comes to mind for somebody who would have been able to source the kind of rituals that would have been needed to create this and to keep it permanent and to keep it working. Zarastro, so I'm trying to work out, doesn't give me a date. Zarastro about 10 years ago moved from Muluk. And you know that he lived somewhere outside the city, but within within travelling distance of Muluk. So whether or not this was he moved to, like I say, 10 years previously. But such was his power that Nabil has heard of him. None of which helps you with knowing how to activate it. You are back to it is a word, and trying to divine that word will be incredibly difficult.
Does anyone bring a dictionary with them? So we could start at A and take it in turns.
We don't know which language. So there's more than one dictionary.
Bring a GCSE English to Spanish dictionary. We start with A.
And we'll use French and Italian.
None of which are spoken in Zakara, but...
Did think that.
Well, let's try Zarastro. Let's say Zarastro out loud and see if that does anything for us.
Yeah.
Good thought, but no, it doesn't.
So is our best bet to hide someone and hang about for a caravan to come up and say the word?
Yeah, I think we should camp out and then jump whoever comes up.
That might not work.
They seem quite well guarded, but...
We can take them.
Yeah,
well, we don't necessarily have to take them. We can do some dancing lights, ghost sound, play with their head, kind of woo stuff.
It's working well on that camera.
Woo! All right, I am aware of the time. So I think this is probably not a bad place to draw this to a close.
Yep.
So if we say that you guys decide you're going to camp out, whether or not you leave somebody down by the side of the trail, or whether you all camp at the top, or kind of what kind of plan you come up with.
I think we should go back around the corner to the road where we can see back down the trail a bit.
Yeah.
So we get some advance warning of somebody coming.
All right. What I'm going to suggest is, if we draw to a close, that you guys get off the trail, maybe climb to the top, try and work out what you are going to do. We've got a fortnight real time before we play again, So do you guys want to get together Facebook Messenger, phone calls, email, whatever between yourselves, and spend some time coming up with a cunning plan, and we'll get back together in a fortnight.
Yeah, that makes sense to me.
Yep.
All right, I'm going to stop the broadcast.
Are we live? Are we